Please be joined now by Delegate Warren Miller. He's a Republican, District 9A, to be specific. He represents portions of Carroll and Howard Counties. Good to have you on. I know that you were underwhelmed, I think is a fair word to describe your reaction to the governor's reopening plan on Friday. Why so?
Well, thanks for having me on, Brian. I've got a lot of small business owners in my district that are, you know, facing the end of their business. I've got a lot of people trying to get unemployment insurance. So they've been trying for weeks with no success. And if our economy, if we don't find a way to reopen it soon, you know, these aren't Wall Street companies or small companies or the restaurants we're used to, the small businesses that are considered non-essential. If we can't find a way soon to get these people at least some predictability and some reason to want to stay, they're going to be closing up their shops. And this is going to happen for a lot of the state.
Throughout the rest of the state. Well, like, what do you think the timetable is?
Well, the governor outlined in his plan, which finally came out last week, that it's 14 days from a peak in hospitalizations. And we're, you know, as your channel has reported, we're still seeing the number of infections rise. That being said, if you're a small business and you've got, I don't know, three or five people, you don't have the public in your business, and you're not allowed to open, you're not allowed to work because you're non-essential, that's a problem. We have, I'll give you one example, you know, coin-op car washes. They're closed right now. They're being, a couple places in the state, they're being fined for operating. There are no people there. You know, you're in a car, you go through, it's all self-serve. You have to be careful about the surfaces you touch, but that's an example of a business that right. could be open right now.
You know, I've often wondered that, and the governor says, well, these are the federal guidelines that were put in place. Like, you know, it doesn't make much sense that a liquor store can open, but like you said, a car wash can't open, or you can't go out on a boat. Have you heard from him, or have you pushed him on that, and why they're adamant that they have to go through these federal guidelines and not just do it on their own?
So the federal guidelines or recommendations are put in place in the very beginning of this, and I understand why the state followed those. But there's no reason we're now seeing, you know, states like Georgia and Texas moving away from those guidelines. They're already starting to reopen some of these businesses. And like I said, I mean, the longer we wait, the more impact's being done on multiple levels. We're seeing, I'll give you another example of a sector of our economy that's really hurting, elective surgeries at hospitals.
Oh, yeah, I know that.
We just saw not long ago Hopkins probably looking at huge layoffs. They're looking at $100 million in losses through June 30th of this year. We have some hospitals throughout the state that weren't on the desk of fiscal rounds before this all occurred, and they're now turning away, you know, roughly 50 to 70% of the business they see on a daily basis to elective surgeries. And that's another place where our economy is really going to be hurt. When we hear about, animal growers on the Eastern Shore that are having to slaughter the younger animals because the supply chain's failing. These are all scary things for our economy.
I don't disagree with you one bit on that. And I wonder if we don't really fully understand the economic impact that we're about to see. But having said all of that, I mean, the governor and a lot of the other, you know, executives and even health experts will say, even if you open it up tomorrow, there are a lot of people who wouldn't even want to go to a restaurant or wouldn't want to go to any of these things. And some of these businesses may actually wind up being hurt even more if they opened up and they could only get, you know, 20% capacity of what they're normally get from the revenues. I mean, isn't just this the hand that we're dealt at this point?
I think part of it's the hand we're dealt, but I also think that you know, there are certain restaurants that are doing extremely well right now. Without a doubt, the drive-thru restaurants that, you know, the chains, they've never been closed. They haven't had to face any of the economic hardships. Strangely enough, out in my districts, I did see that, you know, it was a misunderstanding or a business decision that a number of the Dunkin' Donuts closed right when the stay-at-home order started.
Mm-hmm.
So I think restaurants, that sector of the economy are mixed bag about whether people are doing okay or not. But there again, if we can't find a better way to help these businesses, some of them are going to fail.
I'm curious, you know, you're one of the few that's willing to go out there and say these things in Annapolis. Do you feel your colleagues are shy to voice their opinions on this? Do you have an idea if there are more people who are kind of feel the same way with you on this?
All I can tell you is whether they're vocal or not, they're receiving the same emails and calls that I've been receiving from small business owners. And I've reached the tipping point in that I'm willing to be vocal because I have a number of longtime Howard County and Carroll County businesses where people have been reaching out to me with their concerns. And they've been honest and frank with me. And I believe that to have the role I have to be outspoken on their behalf. There are people that applied for SBA loans that didn't get them. They applied for State Department of Commerce loans that didn't get them, that are now resorting to try to get unemployment insurance, and they're having difficulties with that. I mean, it seems like everywhere they turn, they're not being well supported. And these programs all sound great until you see the execution of them, and they're just not working the way they should or the way they're promised to be.
Yeah. Delegate, good to have you on. I really appreciate you coming on the show. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Delegate Warren Miller, Republican, who represents portions of Carroll and Howard counties on the impact this is having on a lot of small businesses that are in his district and what he is hearing on a regular basis.